Update: Am I the butthole for telling my girlfriend I'd like her to dress up when we go out? I'd like to say thank you to everyone who commented. This community may very well have saved my relationship. I spoke to my girlfriend. First, I apologized to her and then I told her that she seemed to get uncharacteristically upset at the comment I made, and if there was anything else she wanted to talk about. It took a bit of coaxing, but eventually she opened up to me and told me that she had gained weight during quarantine and felt uncomfortable in her body. She said she didn't want to buy new clothes because she felt embarrassed admitting to me that she was a larger size now, but she didn't like the way her old clothes looked on her. I told her, honestly, that to me she still looked as beautiful as when we began dating, and that I had not even noticed her fluctuating weight. We have begun a workout regimen at home. It's like CrossFit, but the workouts are only 15 to 20 minutes, so we do one in the morning and one at night. We've also, sadly, cut out all the junk food at our house. It sucks, but luckily she's a really good cook and makes zucchini pasta and kale chips not suck. She said it's too soon to see a difference, but I personally think she already looks like she's getting leaner. To answer a question a lot of people were asking, about the comment she made about why don't I go sleep with my best friend's girlfriend, no, I did not tell her I wish you dressed more like X or anything like that. Her ex cheated on her and slept with his friend's girlfriend. I guess when she got upset it's just something she jumped to saying. Again, thanks for all of your great advice. Web link. Who? Well done up, I grew up witnessing and have been in many relationships where the communication was awful, seeing stuff like this is awesome. Thank you very much. Would love some delicious kale chips and zucchini recipes. Trying to get healthy myself. Hey, I have a kale chips recipe. Take the kale, wash it, dry it good, make bite-sized pieces. Take some olive oil, around 2 tablespoons for each 250 grams of kale. Also some pinches of salt, a bit slash a splash to 1 teaspoon of lemon juice or vinegar, if you like it with a bit of sourness. You can also add chili, garlic powder, curry powder, whatever spice you like. Massage it into the kale. If it is the rough tough middle European kale, then massage it a bit longer. Spread on a baking sheet with baking paper and put it in the oven at around 120 degrees Celsius / 250°F for around 20 to 30 minutes, toss and mix from time to time until they are crispy but not too brown. Also you might need to open the window in your kitchen to get the smell out. It's a bit of try and error until you find the spices that are right. The classic German way of eating kale is cooked with sausages. I wouldn't call that healthy, but it's hearty and warming in the cold winters. For zucchini noodles, eat them with red or green pesto and protein-rich food, for example mushrooms, marinated tofu, chicken / turkey, throw the chicken breast into flour, and pan-fry it in a tablespoon of neutral oil, falafel, add a bit of feta cheese. You can also make zucchini omelette. Or ratatouille. Or slice it and fry it with onion and garlic. Eat with whatever you like, fish, lean meat, falafel, maybe a potato, whole wheat pasta, brown rice, pearl barley, etc. I'm not a nutritionist. I just love cooking and experimenting and food in general. Also op, well done. Communicating is so important and I like how supportive you and your girlfriend are to each other, and that she actually opened up to you and trusted you. I was 100%. Convinced your kale chip recipe was going to go make bite-sized pieces, and throw it in the trash because I've been on the internet way too long. It really did start like that. I mean, feel free to adjust the recipe to your liking. That's what I was expecting too. I make cauliflower Alfredo sauce to go with my zucchini noodles. Just boil a head of cauliflower, and then blend it with about a cup of milk and some garlic. It's delicious, and super filling. I love kale chips so much, but I am too addicted to the unhealthy kind with thick layers of cashew cream and ranch / nutritional yeast, hand over mouth. So it hadn't occurred to me to add nooch to kale chips. You may have just changed my life. It is so good. I will mix vegan ranch into cashew cream and add nooch and slather the kale in it before dehydrating it. I have to stop myself from buying kale too much because of it lol. Nutritional yeast is the best on kale chips. But consider, you are still getting the kale, and that is still worth something. The vitamins don't go away just because they're slathered in extra calories. sometimes it's just a process of getting used to a flavor. If you love kale chips with extra stuff, you can start trying them with slightly less extra stuff gradually. Someday you might just like regular kale. Haha, you're right. And I have eaten it crisp and plain and it's still delicious. More love to go around. Soy sauce is really good too and adds a nice smoky, saltiness to kale. It's also great on any veggies that you throw on a grill. Glad that you got to the root of the problem with your girlfriend op. For kale chips, I've added nutritional yeast, Parmesan cheese, onion and garlic powder / dehydrated pieces. I used to add salt, but the cheese and yeast seem to make it salty enough so you can skip the salt, I think. Oh, that sounds amazing. Soy sauce also works, but I wouldn't recommend it with other salty products. Hidden Valley Ranch packet for seasoning, kissing cat face. Damn it, I just got back from the shop and kale was reduced to 50p. I debated getting a bag and decided against it, wish I had grabbed some now. I honestly hated kale, see the kale and sausage comment haha. But kale chips are a game changer. I make a big batch and a day later they are all gone. Honestly not a huge fan of zucchini or mushroom, but this recipe honestly makes me want to eat it. I like nutritional yeast on mine. Saving this post for the recipe. Spiralize your zucchini and add them to spaghetti / linguine / fettuccine, not replace the pasta with them. Don't cook them, just add them at the end so they're still crunchy but warm and coated in sauce. I don't know why you would do that, to be honest. The added crunch tastes good. Also, a really good use of kale is pesto. Make the recipe, but half the basil and add kale as the second half. It makes it less sweet and adds to the garlic flavor. Plus, put that over zucchini noodles and bam, double recipe. Secret to cooking zoodles is to blanch them. I love them still with a bit of a bite, al dente if you will. Cooking them too long makes them mush. And that's how you boyfriend. This is how relationships should work and what makes them last through the years. Communication, support, love and no judgment. Which gave original poster the clue that there was far more wrong with his girlfriend than a simple case of being lazy or slovenly. When she uncharacteristically lost her temper and threw infidelity in his face, it was a red flag waving. Wisely, he didn't ignore it. Of course it wasn't okay. No one ever said that it was. It's not okay to treat your partner like crap when you're sick, but many of us do. It's not okay for a moody pregnant woman to go off on her partner when the hormones are flowing, but it happens. Fortunately, wise people don't just brush these blow-ups off or excuse them or give their partners license to yell at them. They see the yelling as a clue that the situation is one their partner is struggling with, and they dig deeper to get to both the truth and possible solutions. Garnet. And Steven. And my ex. They're taking the hobbits to Isengard. He does need to cook also. That post is 100% contextually different than this. Edit, there were also several folks who said there were a litany of different potential causes of the behavior and how to get around it on that exact post. You're absolutely right, obviously, and I don't know why people are trying to deny it, because just spend 1 hour in this sub and it's overwhelming how often people say to break up after any poor behavior. But where you seem to be going wrong is that you also seem to have that same attitude about breaking up over any poor behavior, as if you disapprove of the way it was handled here. The reality is that we all have bad days. We all have blind spots in our behavior. We all get emotional about certain things more than others. We are all imperfect and sometimes we can be a great match for someone, and a genuinely good person, but we just need to be reasoned with about one particular thing that we are oversensitive about. What the boyfriend here gave the girlfriend was a bit of love, forgiveness, even without asking her to apologize, reasonableness, and compassion. That is what things should be like all the time. It is not a bad thing that people here approve of him deciding not breaking up with her. What's a bad thing is that people normally encourage the girl to break the relationship when the genders are swapped. By apologizing anytime you are irrationally screamed at for something that's not your fault. Notice how she never apologized. If a woman put up a story about her boyfriend, he or she asked him if he could dress up for nice occasions and he irrationally screamed his head off at her and accused telling her to go sleep around with some other better-looking guy they knew and acted extremely and irrationally jealous, then she came back and said, "I apologize to my boyfriend and now we're really good." Do you honestly think this sub would go, "And that's how you girlfriend?" Or would they tell her she should have dumped him in the original post? Be honest. I found the butthole. It seems like they are communicating well and talked it out thoroughly. Just because it wasn't in the update doesn't mean she didn't apologize original post or just probably didn't think to mention that. Oh, sure. Benefit of the doubt. Funny how that is doled out on this sub. Be honest, if a woman put up a story about her boyfriend here she asked him if he could dress up for nice occasions and he irrationally screamed his head off at her and accused telling her to go sleep around with some fit guy they knew and acted extremely and irrationally jealous, then she came back and said, "I apologize to my boyfriend and now we're really good." Do you honestly think this sub would go, "And that's how you girlfriend?" Or would they tell her she should have dumped him in the original post? Be honest. You won't answer the question. Exactly my point. I think it matters that original poster was extremely clear that this was very out of character for her. That makes a big difference and suggests that something else may be wrong. Original poster knows his partner better than we do. Yes, I honestly do. Some people will always be stuck in their bias, and that goes both ways, but a lot of people on this sub are very empathetic and really read and judge each situation individually. If original poster had written about his situation in the style you are, I would have told him it sounds very manipulative, and he should watch out for future patterns of manipulation / reconsider the relationship. But he said it's out of character for her, and then they took steps to build their relationship stronger together. The girlfriend is taking responsibility by taking what upset her into her own hands and not blaming original poster for it, and he's being a good boyfriend by joining her on her weight loss journey. Most of the posts I see where people all jump instantly to dump them is when there is a long pattern of manipulative behavior that gets worse over time. This is not that. And that is not a gender thing. Literally whenever I've seen posts where men scream at their girlfriends on here and it's not a constant pattern of him throwing fits at her about every little thing, most of the comments advise her to find out what's causing a sudden change in their partner. Including a woman being fully blasted as the butthole after body shaming her partner for gaining weight during the pandemic because I have kept up the effort so why can't he? Does anyone else feel like posters who blanket statements like you won't X and that's exactly my point are just going to get your comments deleted so they can enshrine their worldview? There are plenty of reasons to delete comments including harassment and death threats, both of which I have received in the past. The last harassment was in the last 2 months where I was literally being followed into different subs for 2 weeks. Just as practical however is that the reason comments get deleted are because unpopular opinions will get you banned from the sub, because when you try to defend an unpopular opinion, it is considered petty arguing and gets you banned from the sub for prolonged spats in the comments. You can make whatever baseless claims that you want, but that's how it works. A. I don't know. You honestly think this sub would encourage a woman to apologize to her boyfriend after he irrationally screamed at her for being asked to wear nice clothes on dressy occasions? Nice work. Keep telling her she's beautiful. I certainly will. If she can make kale chips good, she is clearly a wizard. Seriously, can we have the kale chips recipe up? I know a good brand, Brad's Crunchy Kale if anyone wants to try it. Vampire Killer and Spicy Nacho are the best flavors, but they're expensive and I can't keep buying them, smiley face. Salt and pepper, MSG, either pure or use something natural that contains it, mushroom sauce, tomato paste, W/E, or yeast flakes, that alone will pretty much make most food taste great to be honest. Depending on taste you can add herbs or spices, no one's banning you from eating curry kale chips or Mediterranean ones. You can also try to go with the salt and vinegar variant, as that's a quite powerful combination. Definitely some good ideas, thank you. I think I might go the salt and vinegar route, maybe use some apple cider vinegar. Miso could work for the MSG/umami component too, I'm more than a little obsessed with chickpea miso these days. It saved many a boring soup and makes the best hummus. I grew up vegetarian with parents who owned a few small vegetarian/vegan cafes and kale chips were a staple for us in my house, Everyone's left great tips, so my main tip to add on is to not undercook them. Make sure you let them get super crispy and shake the pan halfway through like you would with baked fries, maybe even test some of the kale chips towards the end of the process to make sure they're crunchy enough for your taste. Also, if you enjoy heavily flavored type more, don't forget to lightly salt and add whatever seasonings you enjoy after you bake, as well as before. Some of the flavor will disappear in the oven, so it just helps keep the flavor at the forefront of the chip. I tend to do 350, enough olive oil to coat it with each kale leaf small, parmesan and garlic on the tray, parchment paper, and cook for 10 to 15 minutes. Brussels sprouts separated make for pretty good roasted chips, by the way. Outer leaves make the chips, roast the insides on the other side of the baking sheet as a side for dinner. Ooh! I love Brussels sprouts. Add a tad bit of salt and a half tsp of real butter and you've got yourself a right fine side dish or snack. Seriously. I like kale just fine, so kale chips seemed like an easy way to cure salt munchies. Every time, they're pretty nasty and taste burned. They're easy to burn before they get crispy. Try a lower temp for longer, like a previous commenter mentioned above, 250 degrees Fahrenheit for 20 to 30 minutes. Be sure to squish and massage them before baking if they're tough, as that also helps with the texture. Sometimes I cook it on the barbecue too. The low slow might help. I've just never seen something to go fine part of salad to charcoal chips so fast. Massaging them was something I never thought of and will try. Thank you for the wholesome update. It is nice to see a couple with healthy communication and positive support for one another. Communication saves the relationship, nice job. Great job communicating. Now I want some kale chips. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to be the first to know about Red Rabbit Reader's new videos. If you like our videos, please like them on YouTube and share them with your friends. We welcome your comments below. Press to start another of our videos.